Thank you, Sahil. So coming back to the presentation, thank you for the opportunity. So what we are doing is, so on behalf of IIM-L Incubator, we are one of the incubatees at IIM-L Incubator, and this company is so we have done R&D for last almost 8 to 10 months before we come up with a commercialized product. We just want to share over here kind of open source platforms which can be used to do R&D and come up with a commercialized product. So I'm going to showcase, and we have just keep it very concise and just to showcase the power of open source, and it can give you the flexibility of trying too many things, because if you're trying to solve a business problem. So Constance is the company. So we have just, since we are going to the market now, Constance is the company. I'm one of the founders. We have, and we are commercializing the product. So the whole context which we are trying to share across, that the assumption is that you guys know the basic fundamentals of open source and what it can do. This is an actual use case. We'll try to showcase that how powerful it can be. Because if you're trying to solve a business problem, you cannot go ahead and try to get into a very structured method. You have to go do a more of a blue sky thinking, and that's what open source platforms provide you. So as an agenda, I'll just simply share the objective, what we'll try to cover as a part of this presentation, a bit of a context. Context is more from learning which we derive from whatever the open source platforms we use, especially the Python, OpenCV, and then we'll get into the use case, the kind of product, what kind of hardware, softwares, and what is coming out to be. So we presented this. So we are doing presentations from last almost 2 months. Once we are ready with the product. So I presented the same thing in Europe. So whatever we have come up with last week, and whatever we have come up with, it's what's been categorized as is pretty cutting edge, and it's being done. It's still being tested out across the world. So as an objective, it's a use case. So very clear that without getting into the technicalities, how it can come to real life. And that's what's been showcased to you as a form of our product or the application. So requirement, when we started with the overall thought that there is a business problem what we have, there was a requirement which being put together or put forth by my tech team, that we need to have a platform which can facilitate, or where we can do a faster development. We can test out multiple ideas, because people are still struggling to crack the problem in the South Asia markets. So before this, I was part of a couple of tech companies. And of course, as a company like Samsung, we are still struggling to crack the problem like this. So we wanted to test out our ideas so that we can come up with a solution. And of course, adaptability and integration across, because given the South Asian markets, people are looking for something which can, of course, not only plug and play, which can talk to multiple systems and processes, and that's what that system or product can facilitate us. So, of course, we used Python, and these are the basic learnings. I'll get into the actual use case. We built up a set of people, primarily from campuses only. There are, of course, the CTOs and the senior people are those who are working with me, in centralized location, but most of our test engineers are based out of campuses, remote locations. So whenever we are writing codes and all that, can it be integrated, can it be tested, and all of that. So that's where the learning was. Of course, it has to have an easy integration capability. Of course, people don't struggle to understand the code, and that's why readability and understanding has to be faster. Of course, building, debugging has to be faster, and that's where the Python was one of the primary choices, and the availability of packages across, because the kind of problem we picked up, it was not being addressed as of now in the market. And the result or the output is Constance. So we call ourselves, it's an AI and immersive solution company. Immersive solution is when we get into an AR and VR, which this platform has got a flexibility to get integrated with. A real-life problem, what we picked up, so basically it has got a potential to go much beyond it, but at this stage we are focusing on retail, which is a physical retail market, where what's going on in that physical retail market. Retailers are struggling, whether it's any kind of retailer, whenever you go to the market. So whether it's a shopper, what shopper is doing, what is happening in the store, what is happening in your premises, any kind of problem. So there is no control that retailer has on that. And what is the productivity ROI? So few of you understand the retail market, they operate on a very thin margin, and Indian retail market is struggling to make profit there, apart from one or two groups. So that's the problem we wanted to address, and that's where this product comes in. And whatever the products available in the market as of now, nobody is addressing this problem in totality, which we intend to address. So, of course, the approach was use existing hardware. So when I say existing hardware, I'll come, the next slide will explain you what existing hardwares are. Use existing hardwares, and the whole products can get integrated or can be plugged in with the existing hardware in the store, in the retail, or with the... So if, say, for example, if tomorrow Samsung says that I have 2,000 stores and I use these hardwares in my store, whether it's an EPOS system or a video camera or any kind of IoT device, can go and talk to it and start taking my... So retailers' inputs to start intervening in the sales, marketing, operation activities. And of course, faster time to market, because the problem is not being addressed. So the idea was that if we experiment with something, what is the time frame? So of course, although we take 8 to 10 months right from the conceptualization to getting into a POC stage and deploying in the retail market, the objective was that we can test out something with, given the condition that required security issues and all that being addressed, and then we can take it to the market. So as of now, at this stage, we have gone ahead and used these kind of hardwares, whatever there in the stores of few of our brands. So it's so if I were to put it across, it uses computer vision. Cameras which are deployed in the store. There are login systems and mechanisms which are deployed in the store. There are beacons, ID trackers, or any kind of Mac ID trackers which are deployed in the store. This product can talk to. As a process, the last 8 months was an experimentative process where we went ahead, we picked up various pieces of the information, did a bit of experimentation, picked up videos from net, and ran our product on to as a test case, what is coming out. And of course, so I'm just showing some pictures, some output, some learning which came out of that. It's all been done on open source, and especially Python and OpenCV, to come up with an output, whether it is addressing the business solution. The objective was to reach to this kind of output. Of course, there are players in the market which are doing it partially, but yes, can it be taken to that level? So we are somewhere in between. We haven't reached there, but yes, as a solution, we are. So all these problems or all these output is being addressed as of now in the product. Basis this experimentative case, so I'll show you two videos where we have reached to a level what product is doing as of now, and we are already there in the market in terms of deploying. So we are not going in terms of with an explosive expansion stage, but yes, we are trying to stabilize the whole thing, and that's where the product is in terms of with few stores trying to stabilize. So this video doesn't. There's a deployment which is already there. There are a set of cameras and there are EPOS systems. So this is more at the backend engine. What happens rather than the dashboard, which you see in the triangle, that everything comes together in the form of a dashboard, and where the AI starts taking inputs and start making changes and correction to the store operations. And this is more of a output and after the effort which we have put in terms of when after that whole experiment and research which we did from last 6 to 8 months. So, and this is a real-time case. What we have done is the biggest challenge was also to bring down the kind of data transfer, the current existing product and solutions which are deployed in the market. our product brings out the data transferred at a minimal level. So for example, for one day, a video transfer, a video kind of data, it took almost 20 GB data transfer on a month on a week on week basis, where we brought it down to 2 or 3 GB. So that's the kind of data cost we are saving on. Also, the kind of actionability and the interaction that the AI does with the retailer or the brand. So these are the, and of course there are multiple algos and multiple interaction, and these are the few cases which we are showing over here from a relevance perspective. So if you see the whole grayscaling and all that is happening to address the problem of bringing down the data cost, which was one of the biggest challenges which we struggled when we got into the overall product development stage. So to conclude the whole thing, of course, there was a business problem which being identified basis certain business expertise which we had as a team, and we identified a platform to experiment with. We toyed around with multiple approaches and came down to one approach where the whole algo or the script being evolved to a stage where it adapts to various environments. Of course, the cost was one of the biggest challenges to enter the market. Last week when we were presenting in Europe, the challenge was the cost, and where we are quite competitive and quite reasonable vis-a-vis any other market conditions. Of course, faster time to market. If you were to say 8 months is quite reasonable versus a French company which is working on similar lines, they are working on something like this from last 2 years. And of course, integration capability. So when I say integration capability, of course, somebody is in Europe also trying to do something like that, but at a much higher cost. So that's what it is as a output which came out using something like Python, which we utilized in last 8 to 10 months to do our experimentation and came up with a product. Yeah. So that's all from our side. Yeah. Thank you. Deploy the same system, we need next 2 months or 3 months, because it's, learning, this is an environment adaptive system. So if I deploy in your retail store, in your environment, give me 1 or 2 months, and that's the way we are talking to clients and brands, but give me 1 or 2 months to adapt to your environment, your accuracy starts improving month on month and quarter on quarter. So don't expect that it will give you an accurate. So if I were to quote a couple of names, Hira and other companies tried entering India. The biggest problem was they were trying to push across an extremely expensive system. This challenge, and not explaining people that, that gender identification would be a challenge from a race and the whole skin tone perspective if I move from one country to another. But of course, they are pretty accurate in Europe, but when they come over here, the same thing will happen to us. But the other capability of the system where it triangulates the data, not too many people are trying to do.
Okay. What about tailgating? I mean, you're able to also handle tailgating. So if you have 2-3 people simultaneously walking,
yeah,
can you still pick up?
So at this stage, currently, so we have